important, Miss Emma, and they stay with you?
Now, look, there are lots of kids your age in that home. It can't be that bad, love.
I hate it. And next time, I'm taking Emma. They'll never find us.
Hey, what about your mother? Now, she's been very worried about you.
Well, I'll tell her where we are.
Listen, darling. I know what it's like being somewhere you hate. Well, I hate being here, but I haven't run away, now have I?
Why not?
Well, because they'd only come after me and catch me and bring me back, and then I'd have to stay even longer.
When are you coming to get us?
As soon as I can. I promise.
I'm sorry. Time's up.
Could Mr. Reed tell my solicitor I want to see her?
All right, I'll let him know.
As I see it, I've got two alternatives. Either I can sweat it out in here, hoping to heaven my kids don't run off again, or I can put my life into hock and go to court.
Pat, there is legal aid, and you know that.
Yeah, I know. Look, I know we've been through all this before. I'm just trying to get it straight in my head. The way I see it, I'm gambling on getting off. If I don't get off, well, either way, my kids could end up without a roof over their heads.
Well, it's your decision. Nobody's forcing you into it. If you need more time to think
about it. Time? Look, time's not going to alter the fact that I've ruined my kids' lives. I've just seen Andrew. Yeah, he needs me, I know that. But he needs a good education, too, and a decent home. And everything a kid needs to get started in life. Everything his father never had. And Emma might marry the first bloke who comes along just to get out of some flea trap that we're living in. I'll watch them grow up hating the world and then end up in a place like this. That's what I'm offering my kids.
Pat, there's not a parent alive who can be absolutely certain how their kids are going to turn out. You can give them everything in material terms, but they can still go off the rails if there's no love or security. And I think that you've got more than enough of that to give. Okay? Okay, I'll make the arrangements with Miss Saunders.
Well, I lived around horses a lot when I was a kid. But what I really wanted was my own dog. You know, I used to pretend that I had one. Well, that was when I was by myself. Mm-hmm.
Well, oh, how'd it go?
I'm going ahead with the appeal.
Well, good for you.
Yeah, I suppose so. Mum will have to sell the house. Not that she owns much of it, but it'll help.
Could I have your attention, please? For those of you who are interested, the drama classes will commence tomorrow afternoon.
Oh, great.
There have been various classes in the past, most of which have been dropped due to lack of enthusiasm or because the privileges were abused. I'm hoping these will be successful. However, should there be any difficulty at all, they will be stopped immediately. I'm expecting the women involved to set an example. Thank you.
It's not there.
The RSPCA have come to collect the dog. It seems to have disappeared. Do any of you know where it could be?
Who was the last to see it?
Well, I suppose it was Judy and me, but it was okay then. We tied it up just like Miss Bennett said. It must have got out.
All right.
Probably we wanted to get away from you.
I'll cut it out, Miss Sharon.
What are you siding with her for? She everyone's little pet or something.
Look, I'm not in the mood, okay?
The manager let me in. Hope you don't mind.
Of course not.
The thought it'd be the safest place we could meet.
You're a hard man to find, mate. I had to resort to following you home from work.
What do you want?
Well, no wonder you didn't tell Leela where you were staying.
Excuse me. I've got to be going.
Aren't you going to introduce us?
Sorry. I'm sorry. I'll give you a call, all right?
You know they dropped the charges that I was recruiting mercenaries?
No, I didn't know.
Yeah, they had me under surveillance for weeks. Couldn't prove anything. So now the only rap I've got to beat is the assault on me.
I see.
I've really been having a pretty hard time of it, mate. This whole mess has ruined me. I can't get a job, I'm skint.
Well, look, if you need a few bucks, I can always...
I'm not asking for a handout, mate. Well, I want another chance.
What do you mean?
Do I have to spell it out? Any chance of a drink?
Yeah, help yourself.
If I can clear this one, mate, I'll get out of the country. Go somewhere where I'm useful. I'm a fighting man. Always have been. If you take that away from me, I'm nothing. Besides, you can't hit a man when he's down. Particularly for something he did when he was off the air. And I did give you a chance back in Nam, remember?
I haven't forgotten.
Well, that's all I want, mate. Another chance. To two bloody good mates.
Going to be OK out there all by herself.
Yeah, well, after the scrubbing we gave her, someone's bound to want her.
I suppose it's better than being in an old dog's home where someone might put her to sleep.
Birdsworth? Are you feeling all right, Birdsworth?
Yeah, just thought I'd turn in early, Miss Bennett.
She must be crook.
Are you sure you're not sick?
Quite sure, honest.
Did that get there?
Oh, I must have spilt me glass of water.
Oh, crikey. Yeah, Lizzie, have you heard the song Doreen's rehearsing for the playgroup?
Will you women get out of here?
Oh, come on, today.
Out before lights out, Miss Bennett.
You've got the cutest little baby face.
What a sideshow.
And not another one can take your place. Baby face.
Look, Smith, will you be quiet and listen to me? Or I'll put you on report.
Baby face.
Shut up. For this piece of stupidity, you can lose your privileges. Now get out of here.
You got no taste for the arts. That's your problem, Vera.
Smith, I'm sure when the RSPCA call again tomorrow, they're more than likely to find a dog in the garden, don't you think?
Wouldn't be at all surprised, Mrs. Jackson.
What were you looking for, Miss Bennett?
You don't fool me for a second, Birdsworth.
Of all the stupid harebrained things to do, Lizzie.
Oh, well, I couldn't leave her out in the garden. That's how my cat dropped dead.
But how are we going to smuggle her past the screws? If Vera sees us with this mutt, she'll throw the book at us. And if those drama classes get cancelled because of you,
I figured out a way, B.
But what are you doing in here?
I thought we could smuggle her out to the bin in this. Good thinking, Dor.
Yeah, I could take her out.
I'll do it.
You had her in your room last night after I did all the dirty work.
It's not fair.
Well, you knock it off, you two, and just get it out of here.
She gets to do everything.
Well, who cares? It's going to be taken away anyhow.
Look, you're not meant to be in the garden.
And you're not meant to be in the laundry, you little baby.
I'll get both your blocks off.
You're using threats again, Smith. I thought if I kept an eye on Anderson, she'd lead me to the dog. You're all slipping.
Oh, I was just keeping her until I let her go, Miss Bennett. I don't want her to go to the RSPCA.
You should have thought of that before.
Oh, what's going to happen to Prudence if nobody wants her?
They'll destroy her. What do you think?
Oh, you wouldn't let them do that, would you, Miss Bennett? Just because you never had a dog when you were a kid, there's no need to hate her that much.
Don't push me, Birdsworth.
Shut up, Lizzie.
Well, Smith, I'm glad to see you're...